I dag der skal vi spille et spil, der hedder Major Minor. Det er måske Fury-baseret spil, men jeg siger jer, det er virkelig et spil, som jeg virkelig, virkelig godt kan lide. Og jeg beklager virkelig, mit engelsk, det er nok ikke lige det bedste. Så vi tager det bare fra den ende af, og så må jeg se. Using modable save files is highly recommended. Both keyboard and controller are supported for input. F4 will enter window mode, F5 will return to menu. Okay. Please enjoy and choose wisely. Det er rigtig nok, det her spil her, det er virkelig, det går virkelig meget ud på, at man skal vælge med omhu. Where am I? Is this outer space? No, it absolutely can't be. I'd never survive in the void. I scan my surroundings. What I see should be an impossibility. A luminescent nebula gazes back at me. It twinkles, dancing across the sky. It's beautiful, but I'm not here to stargaze. As I take this scenario, I notice some key things. My feet are not on solid ground. I appear suspended. And for some reason, I'm able to hear and breathe. Those are not two things you can't do in space. I count this as a blessing and focus on breathing. There were exercises I could use to calm myself down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Before I can count any higher though, I'm interrupted. At that moment I realize I'm not here by myself. I feel a hand rest upon my shoulder, and I shiver. I expect to feel fear, but a rush of calm overtakes me. Hello, and welcome to the Ark. This is a very special place, you see. Only a select few are allowed to be here. This is home to those who touch by fate. Endowed with power, with a power most will call affection. Most will call it fiction. Others have come, but it's your turn. First and foremost, I require a name. Something to enter in the annals of time. We must ensure that you aren't forgotten. Prøv lige at se det pas lige. Fantastisk. Line dash. It's a nice ring to it.
Why, thank you!
Ooh, you're so kind. I'm sure you will be remembered. My name, you ask? I'm afraid that's not important. Hvorfor ikke? No one will remember me after this. Men sagde han ikke lige før, at folk der kom herover, de vil blive husket?
Yeah.
Your presence here portends a grand fate. Not just for you, but the universe too. That is the purpose of those who come here. To that end, what else do they call you? Your surname is just as important. And out of curiosity, I must know. Line dash. Ostemad. Lion Dash Ostemad. Very well. The pleasure is mine. In giving me your name, the deed is done. Your service to me and the Ark is pledged. But do not worry. You're not a slave. Your service rewards you with the power. Something that most would kill to achieve. Others must bend to the rules of the world. But for you, the opposite rings true. You are no longer a victim to this of circumstance. When you make a choice, reality will bend. Your every whim will fall to your lap. The universe now accommodates you. This is the power granted to you by the Ark. This is the power granted to you by me. Oh, it appears that you're fading away. Do you long to return to Earth? I understand. There's a fear in the unknown. I will find you again, soon.
and perhaps then we can talk a little more. Don't be scared, Landash. I mean no harm. Sådan. I feel a rush of speed as I'm shot back into my body. It was almost as if my spirit momentarily left me. Who was that man? And just, what was the Ark? I scratched my head in a state of sheer confusion. I definitely wasn't a dream. I know that for sure. When you wake up from a dream, you know it wasn't real. You laugh it off and continue with your life. That's not the situation I'm feeling right now. I try to ground myself in reality. I take in my surroundings, the noises and people. I focus on my destination, Tokyo, Japan. I feel myself calm down, slowly but surely. The anxiety starts to replace it with excitement. Though many would argue what the difference is. Who didn't dream of going to Tokyo in their lifetime? I had to be on the bucket list of a million people. And it was the first of many places I'd visit. On what would surely be the best year of my life. I sit here holding my armrest with a fierce grip. It won't be long until I figure how wrong I was. Chapter 1. The Calm Before the Storm.
Fantastisk.
I tried my best to maintain my composure. A can of pop star held firmly on my grasp. I wasn't one to drink energy drinks so leisurely, but I picked up what you might call an addiction. For a little bit more context, I'll say this. Popstar was the leading brand of energy drink. In fact, it was almost as popular as soda. It had full endorsement from the famous pop idol. A contest was held to coincide with this idol's new tour. Two special cans were then thrown into the wild. Those that found them got to travel with the tour, almost like a golden ticket from an old childhood story. The contest made the drink skyrocket in popularity. It took the world by storm, a cultural phenomenon. The chance to live a life luxury was hard to pass up. In case you didn't know, the name of the idol was Claes. So when I say I picked up something of an addiction, that might actually be an understatement of the year. The odds of winning were literally in billions, so it took a fair amount of chugging in order to win. I asked myself if it was worth it, but that's subjective. At least that's what I told myself in between jitters. Being one of the lucky two came its consequences. That's what the media called the prospective winners. Before I can continue thinking, I'm interrupted. Someone walking down the aisle has a nasty fall. They brace their descent and land on the seat beside me. That takes a special kind of skill, doesn't it? He quickly rises to his feet, wearing the look of panic. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. I nod my head. It's not the end of the world. Aside from a minor frightening, everything's fine. Although maybe we could talk to pass time. I was starting to get boring sitting by myself. First time on a train. Don't know what came over me. I just got dizzy and then BAM! Sounds like he had a case of vertigo. I apologize again. Sorry for intruding, I really am. I try to explain to him that everything is fine. But he seems to think he committed an awful crime. Your choices will affect the way you are treated. They can also change the flow of the story. Remember, it's not possible to please everyone. Before I can respond, however, the alarm sounds loudly. The train comes to a screaming halt. Mechanical failure? That's not good.
Oh no! What was that? Are we going to die?
I can't help but snigger at that. He's clearly one of those catastrophic thinkers. Yeah, okay.
Good thing I brought a conch. Now I can be in power if we're stranded.
He goes to rummage through his bag. A bit of bookworm too, isn't he? I decide to just sit back and wait it out. In situations like this, there's nothing else to do. I try to think of how I could pass time. It might be a while until we'd be mobile again. I can't use my phone for anything other than texts. The data charges while aboard were a dead sentence. But everybody back home would already be asleep. There was quite a time difference at play here. My phone vibrates as I got to look at it. Almost as if it knew I was thinking about it. It's Rook, the man I'm meeting at the train station. Are you almost here? Can't wait all day, you know. He's wondering where I am, and I'm not sure what to say. I should play it cool or let him know that we're... Ah, okay, det er nu her med, hvor tingene de... Okay. Jamen, jeg tænker jo sådan lidt, fordi man ved jo ikke, om hvor lang tid det kommer til at tage i toget. Så, I can't say for sure. Det er like... Det var en hurtig start. Men I chose to be honest with them. Wouldn't want to get things off a bad start. But somehow I feel like that's actually what happened. Oh my god. Uncertainty, my least favorite thing to hear. Very well. His reply signals the feeling of this content. But there was nothing I could do. And of course, I was truthful. I could rest easy. I noticed that the squirrel also eagerly texted away. I put my phone back in the pocket and reclined my seat. I wasn't actually sure how Rook was related to Clay's. But he had to be pretty high up there. I was only given concrete details last week. I've thought that'd be a limos and media coverage. But I was quickly told that it wasn't the case. I was getting picked up by a regular guy named Rook. Okay. I wonder if he's go full on cliche. With the last piece of cardboard that says, line dash.
Oh man. I really hope we'd be okay. My train ride's usually incident-free.
Usually. But he said that he was... Det rigtig nok. He said that it was his first time. Contradicting himself from realizing it.
Well, as fun as awkward silences are... We should probably get to know each other.
That's not, please.
Just in case we're stuck here forever.
Oh, ja, okay, jeg kan godt lide mig og min karakter, vi spiller faktisk meget godt sammen. Ja, okay, fair nok.
You could call me Keela. I'm here too. Well, here to see some friends. What about you? What brings you to Tokyo?
It's nice to meet another English speaker. I only speak Japanese at a preschool level.
I'm about to answer, but I stop myself short. I have flashbacks to when we signed that NDA. I wasn't allowed publicly to reveal why I was here. At least not until the media made it official. But then again, what harm could it do? I'd likely never find itself back to me. Plus Keela could be impressed who I really am. A friend could be great to have while aboard. Some choices have immediate consequences.
Jeg tror, fordi, ja, okay, jeg prøver på at køre en ærlig historie her. Jeg tror, jeg kører stilen med, hvor jeg ikke fortæller ham det. Fordi jeg stoler ikke rigtig på ham. Allerede det der med, hvor man allerede har bemærket, at han måske er lidt way off og løjet, eller hvad fanden. Jeg stoler ikke på ham. Keep it secret. I decided to sneak my morals and don't break the NDA. It was probably for the best. Who wants a lawsuit? If I did let out my secret and word got back to Rook, well,
I'm sure that'd be hell to pay. Oh, you can't say? That's cool, I guess. I'm just here to read. Nothing to hide to my end, really.
Præcis.
I thought he said that he was here to meet his friends. Now he's here to meet his brother? That seems odd. Nothing to hide, huh? I feel bad that I can't tell him. He clearly realizes that I'm hiding something. I'm still really excited.
My first time in Tokyo. Gotta hit all the mad cafes.
Of course. Typical tourist.
What about you? Would you ever go to a maid cafe? I heard they're just the best.
Maid cafe? I like the restaurants and the restaurant culture. However, your waitress actually sits at your table. You converse them with play game.
What? Det lyder virkelig underligt. Men sikkert noget jeg gerne vil prøve.
I don't know. No. Definitely a foreign concept to me. How should I respond to Kila?
Jeg tænker, at jeg gerne vil prøve at se, hvad det er. Også bare for at gøre.
Cool, we'll have to keep in touch. I've looked online at all the tourist sites. And there's some great around in the Akihabara.
Before I continue talking, the train moves again. And the passenger is shaken up by a sudden movement. Kila beams a wide smile, as if this was a major victory.
Well, I was scared for nothing. That didn't really last long at all.
Sure seems like quite the character.
Yeah, det gør han.
If we did end up going to one of the maid cafes, well, there'd be no shortage of entertainment. I wonder if the same could be said of Rook. More importantly, I wonder how he'd treat me. He certainly seems like an interesting guy. For a moment, I'm glad I didn't break my NDA. I don't think I would be able to face him if I did. I found it odd that I'm analyzing my previous actions. As if I could have changed what I've said and what I...
Okay. Det er nok noget et hint til, at hvis man gemmer, og så låter det op igen, hvis man sagde noget, man mente, der var forkert.
Perhaps it was because of the weird vision I had. I can control my own destiny.
Ah, okay, I get it.
What a ridiculous thing to comprehend. If I could control my destiny, I wouldn't be here. I'd probably be off living in a life of luxury. But there's no use in thinking like that. So I stop.
At that exact moment, a pain attacks my chest.
Okay. More pain than I ever felt before. It pulls with my increasingly fast heartbeat. I go to clutch my gut instinctively, only to find out that I can't move. Everyone around me has seemed to frozen in place. I start to panic. I got to focus on my breathing, like before. But I can't breathe, either. I sense someone behind me. And then I feel it. A hand on my shoulder again. The pain fades away and I gasp loudly for air. Is there something about his touch? Terribly sorry for earlier. Our meeting seems to have been cut short. Perhaps you decided to return to Earth? After all, the universe is bent to you now? Am I that frightening? Either way, I sense conflict within you. You think what happened earlier was a dream? Yet now your dream stands before you. I am real. The Ark is real. And the power that you have? Well, yes, it's real too. I am not here to lecture you anymore. Your words and actions are your own. As if the power I've given you. However, you will be asked to help me. You are not receiving this power for free. But I will let you run for free today. When I see you again tonight, I will tell you everything. And then your journey will begin. Ja tak. Okay. I was immediately shot back in my own reality. Or at least the reality I was comfortable with. But I know one thing for sure. That reality happened. The Ark wasn't just a dream. The reality that really happened. The Ark wasn't just a dream. He actually gave me some sort of power. I have no idea what to think right now. The confusion inside me interferes. It's like millions of voices are fighting in my head, trying to make sense of everything that happened.
Hey, I'm coming!
Killer stands before me, his luggage in tow. I noticed that I also standing up. It appears that my body has moved on its own, almost like something momentarily took over.
Did I say something wrong? Gosh, I need to wash my mouth.
I tell him that he had done nothing wrong. I let him know that I was lost in my own train of thought. He seemed to giggle, as if I was a pun. I decide to take the credit for it. Perhaps I attempt to ease my inner turmoil. At least he waited for me. Or I'd be clueless right now. That's the least thing I'd want to be. Alone and confused in Tokyo. Bad combination. I apologize for the delay as we exit the train. Fright looms over me for the rest of the day. Whatever happened tonight would change everything.
Dun dun dun!
Earlier that day, in the curtains of Terra, a planet far from Earth, yet closer than was known to any.
Ladies and gentlemen, without further delay, I present to you Lord Play, your current leader in the race for mayor. And with that, your further king, future king. I have been his humble servant for years. And though I am certain of one thing, he will bring Terra to an age of prosperity.
Come on now, Riley. You embraced me. I'd rather speak for myself. I'm flattered, but they need to hear me. I shall speak for the propriety of my own. This is something every Terran must hear. Under our current king, we are doomed.
Forgive me, Lord Player. I did not mean to embrace you. Not in front of all these people.
I mean you no cruel, Riley. Have a seat. I'll call you as needed.
Yes, my lord.
Allow me to ask you all a question. You do not need to answer vocally. Just ponder on it as food for thought. If I may paint an image in your minds. You have a starving family. Your only desire is to feed them. You work harder than you ever had done before, but you only have enough food to feed half. The rest of your family will simply starve. Though before you can eat, there's a knock, a violent rapping on the floor of your home. You learn that there's something new to Terra. They fled the destruction of their homes. All they want is a new life on our soil. They beg for all your food, almost dying. But if you feed them, your family will suffer. In this case, charity is a curse. They live, and your family die. So what would you do? Would you help a stranger? Even if it goes to hurt your family? I believe I know what your answer is. Why would I let my family die? Why would I give a stranger my food? I do not blame you if this is your answer. You work so hard for the assistance. Why are you expected to just give it away? Why is Terra expected to give it away? This is the portrait painted in our world. A place to be taken advantage of. Used. We can barely sustain ourselves.
yet we need to care for these immigrants. Your current king is making fatal mistakes. He's giving everything away, really. And he calls himself the Immortal King. If he truly lived for several millennia, well, you're thinking in a common sense. Something Terra has been lacking as of late. Every immigrant we accept. There are another stroke in our canvas, one that paints us as lax and lazy. One more we accept into our world, the more we condemn ourselves to accept. This is the power that the world of mouth. At this rate, we will all die. Regardless of our origin, we will starve. I wanted a strict immigrant law. Even this will not help us. You don't allow a disease to run rampant. We need to cure this blight permanently. A vote for player gives us servants. A disconnect from all other worlds. No longer will they be able to use us. If elected, I will devote my life to this. I will ensure Terra's independence and our base right to live fulfilling lives. Only then will we be free from immigration. Only then will our resource be our own. That is all. Will there be any questions? I have a question for you, Lord Blair. If you are accepting, of course. Please speak, my child. My name is Kaelin.
Jeg ved faktisk ikke, om det er en mand eller en dame. Så spurgte jeg dem.
Please refrain from calling me child. I'm not one of your blind followers. The real problem lies with your greed. You are noble. You have so much food. Why do you hoard and say we've worn short?
What?
If people like you learn to share, well, we'll all be leading happy lives. You're a single man. Yet, I've seen some inside reports. You hoard enough food to feed dozens.
Inside reports?
Jeg kan huske den stemme, jeg gav dem.
Wouldn't it be more fitting to share the supply in the air, Lord Play? Your campaign is based on a lie. And why do you have so much food? You don't look that round to me.
Good joke.
This is why Lord Velasquez. This is why Lord Velasquez wants a teeth. Not on everybody, just the rich. So I don't think you care about our food. Or any resources for that matter. You only care about removing foragers. So my question is, what is the true reason you seek servants?
What is giving you the right to say this?
You're speaking to your future king.
Future king? Don't make me laugh. You're avoiding the question.
Where is your...
Oh fuck, den der melodi bare rundt. Oh, love it. Oh, det lyder godt. Nå, vi skal også videre.
Where is your proof? Associates require evidence, Kaelin.
Jeg kan ikke huske hans stemme.
Something I'm sure you don't have. I laugh at the notion that I am hoarding. Especially enough to feed dozens of people. I know the importance of giving. I would never keep that while others starve.
Really? You fooled me. That story you just told everyone was about not sharing and giving. I asked why you seek servants, and you go to get this defensive. Your heart speaks volumes, Lord Play. There is no need to discriminate here. Everyone deserves food and shelter. Not just those native to Terra.
I seek the servants to be independent. I only want to share amongst our own. I don't want reputation of charity. I want Terra to thrive on its own. If we keep giving things away, we only give a bad image of ourselves.
Well, even if you did achieve servants, we'd still be full of immigrants. Not only that, but their descendants too. How does that make you feel?
Simple. We'd establish a new terror. Once we are served, we'd all be natives. We'd be united as one self-sustaining world.
Funny you should bring that up now. Rebranding our entire world. You think that'd be part of your campaign? Typical politician. Making things up. Turning all the negatives into positives. I'll give you credit, but I'm not fooled.
I ask you for proof, my child.
Fine. Your servant Kabu. Kabu has all of it. He provided a Pegasus shipping manifest. It should be all that we need to prove this.
What?
And then the entire substance is claims. Claims of hearing immigrants hate speech. A nighty pastime of yours, it seems. I'll let him handle it from here.
Oh. 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 I can confirm all that Kaelin said.
Kabu, you traitor! What have you done to deserve this?
At first, I thought Player was my friend. I know I'm not from Terra, but he made me feel wanted, like a son. But he started to hate immigrants so much, I realized more than I can only be used. He just wanted a cheap servant. And now recently, he's been hoarding food, creating nothing but artificial storage. One he can conveniently blame on immigrants, and one that he can use as a cover. He conveniently hides his heart rate while supporting his campaign for mayor. The problem isn't those coming from Terra. It's the greed of those who live in it. Our immortal king speaks the truth. It's heat of the upper class. Yes, then everyone will be fed. Vote for Velasquez. Continued reign.
You know you speak lies.
Why are you doing this, Kabu? Please, look at this shipping manifest. I will place it here for all to see, that you may know Player's true nature. He owns lots of lands on Dera. This is but one of many instances. I'm positive he hoards at his other homes.
Fuck! The evidence is fucked! Do not trust such infidel associations. It was likely created by Velasquez. Riley, have a word with the people. Ensure that realize Kabu's descent. And guards, please detain those two men.
Nah, okay, those two men. Oops, I can't take it in Queen's Den. And if Enoch, we notice that there ain't many people standing around. The initial rush must have already subsided. At least Keela waited for me. How long was I out?
Well, I guess this is it, huh? I kind of pictured a greater entrance. But there's really nobody here. Oh well, I should have expected less. That way I don't get disappointed. It's better getting your hopes up.
That was sure not way of looking at things. Of course, nothing about Keela was normal.
Hey, pull out your phone! We should exchange numbers just in case. I'll be in touch about the mech phase. I read up some really cool ones.
He pulls out his phone, awaits my information. I pull out my phone of my pocket and do the same. After a few moments pass, we exchange our digits.
You got Keela's contact information. Fantastic. Thanks. It was nice to meet you. I'm always glad to make new friend.
Okay. He starts to scurry away. I hope he's a texter. I hate getting phone calls. It seems so weird. Our generation is definitely hooked up on text messages. I wonder where I'm supposed to go. Brooke never gave me any detailed information. I expected he would be right there when I got off. But I don't see anyone at all. Actually, I quickly turn around the corner and bump into a helpless woman.
Hey! Watch where you're going, will you?
I step back and immediately apologize. I tell her I was just looking for my friend Brooke. I explain the fact that I'm a foreigner and...
A foreigner? Oh, so am I. But I'm not so concerned. You should tell your friend to meet you in the atrium.
She pointed towards a large open area. I guess that's a good landmark.
I thank her and start to follow her direction. But before I could go too far, a gasp on my shoulder. Please just give me some peace and quiet. Oh, okay, do I come? Fuck it, you know.
Hey, are you so lonely that you're taking up talking to yourself? That's weird.
I'm extremely relieved. For a moment I thought that we'd be that man again. Det troede jeg også, but no. This must be Rook. What does he mean by talking to myself?
Whatever. I'm glad you're here. The PA speak mentioned possibly delays. And that's not something I can tolerate. We're on a strict schedule. S-T-R-I-C-T.
He starts typing away on his tablet.
Strict. And
oh my god.
Acting in close acting in close company to the requirements of principles.
I fucking get it.
Ever heard of that word before?
Wow. And I thought Kido was a character. Mm-hmm. Although I guess I would be a little upset if he was boring. No one likes a stick in the mud.
So, where's the other one?
I was confused. No, I wasn't quite sure what he meant. I asked him for the clarification.
The other content winner, I mean. You were supposed to be together.
Wait. What?
Insufferable. I hate being lied to. Drop the act. Seriously, where's he?
I tell him I had no idea what he was talking about. I didn't meet anybody. Oh, no. Out of the shelves comes. Yes. Okay.
Hey, you two.
You're watching us? That's insanely creepy. What a group. We have a selfless dog and someone who talks to themselves too.
I really don't get what he means. I was clearly getting directions from that woman.
I wasn't watching you. I was just Jay. Hold on a second. You're the other contest winner?
He really embraces the word you're. I'm unsure if I should take offense to this or not. Yeah, I'm glad I didn't break the NDA. Yeah. Rook will have found out for sure.
I guess I should have expected it. Both on the same train. Both English speakers, it says it all. Oh my god. It adds up. Heh. Well, either way, I have to say I'm really glad it's you. I feel like we've gone along on the train. Even if it was only for a few minutes. We can go to make a face for sure now. We'll be spending so much time together. Isn't that cool? I'm ecstatic.
Ja tak. Det vil jeg rigtig gerne.
A make-cafe, you say? I'd highly advise against that. That's just a waste of time. Plus, you two don't look like the type. Make-cafes attract a certain cliché.
What's that supposed to mean?
Whatever you want it to mean, I guess. Thanks for making plans without me, though. It's nice to know I'm input as valuable.
Jeg tror virkelig, han er sådan en rigtig dejlig type, som jeg ikke kan lide.
Well, what did you have in mind?
Nothing, really.
Så lad være med at bringe det på banen, hvis du alligevel ikke har noget.
I guess that's where you get off lucky. There's been something of a delay. You won't meet Clay's for a day or two. So, my new task is simple. Waste time. I'm supposed to take you where you want. That is, until things are back on track.
Wait, why were you mad? We got to choose where to go. You didn't even have any ideas, Rook.
I'm changing the subject now.
Okay, jeg kan ikke lide ham. Jeg kan simpelthen ikke lide ham.
If you want to go to a make cafe, well, I know a few hot ones to attend. Most of them are in Electric Town.
Electric Town? You don't mean Akihibabara?
Yes, I do. We've all spent lots of time there. It's the place to be for tourists. That and Clay's love the atmosphere. A lot of his outings are in the Akihabara
Wow. We'll get along, Grifton, but you mentioned something came up. Is everything okay? Why the delay?
Oh, it's fine. Liz got into a fight. Him and his tour manager disagreed a lot. But Singer always managed to quell him.
Oh, I hope it's nothing too serious.
It'll be fine. Glaze is a hothead. He'll be fine after venting and relaxing. Anyway, we better get moving. Won't get anywhere standing here all day. It's high time we ditch this situation.
Would you like to save your game?
Yeah,
move away. Nå, jamen jeg tænker i hvert fald som udgangspunkt. Jeg tænker i hvert fald, jeg vil lave en fuld tider ud af det her spil her, fordi det er i hvert fald noget, der virkelig... jeg synes i hvert fald, det er virkelig fedt. Så giv et like på den her video her, hvis I føler for det. Hvis I ikke har lyst til at lade være, det styrer I selvfølgelig selv. Ellers så, hvis I ikke er subscribet til kanalen i forvejen, så lad være. Det bestemmer I selvfølgelig også selv. Ellers så, ja, så synes jeg da bare, at I alle sammen skal have lettere i form af en ekstraordinær exceptionel god dag. Og så håber jeg, I kan lide videoen. Så ses vi på et andet tidspunkt. Det var alt herfra.